The oldest primate that we find in the fossil record belongs to a genus called Teilhardina. In North America, one of those species is named Teilhardina brandti, and that's the fossil that we find here in the Bighorn Basin during the Paleocene-Eocene thermal maximum. When we think of things like monkeys and apes, these are fairly large mammals. These early primates are quite small, more closely resembling the size of things like modern-day mouse lemurs. And in terms of the ecology and diet of these early primates, looking to living primates today in Madagascar that fill this small body size niche is a good way to learn more about their ecology. When Teilhardina brandti was first described, it was described from a single isolated tooth. That was it to name the entire species. It took 15 years before people found jaws of Teilhardina that contained multiple teeth, and another 10 more years after that before people started to find upper teeth of Teilhardina. It wasn't until I first started fossil collecting that I started to appreciate how teeth are a treasure trove of information. As of a few years ago, I think there were maybe 50 teeth known total for this animal, and in addition to that, only a few more bones. However, since we've been working in the Bighorn Basin and using screen washing as a way to capture small teeth in the fossil record from the PETM, we've been able to increase that sample size by 500%. We now have hundreds of teeth of Teilhardina brandti available to study. So as we increased that sample size, we were able to have a better appreciation of the morphological variation within this animal. And what we realized was that some of these features, particularly features about rarely preserved parts of the teeth, indicate that in fact Teilhardina brandti is indeed quite primitive, and as primitive as these other species from other parts of the world. When we make assumptions based on having only a few specimens, it often means that we can miss important parts of the story that tell us how these animals actually lived and how they were actually related to one another. To my knowledge, there is no genus of primates known from anywhere in the world or for all of time that is found in more places than Teilhardina brandti. So we have a record of this same single genus from North America, from Europe, and from Asia, and all of them seem to be occurring during the Paleocene-Eocene thermal maximum. The next primate to exist on all three of those northern continents like that is ourselves, the genus Homo. I think that collecting additional fossils is one of the most important contributions that we can make to understanding this important chapter of the past for all primates and indeed for human beings.